tonight, the long road back for police officer Matt Cooper. We all remember he was shot in the face roughly 8 months ago while chasing a shoplifting suspect in Covington.
Yeah, he spent a number of months at Grady Hospital, then the Shepherd Center. And tonight, after fighting for his life, he said thank you to the people who helped save it. Our Haley Mason was right there. And Haley, there was a lot of emotion tonight in that room.
Sharon, this is actually the program from tonight's ceremony. It was intended to honor the people who helped Officer Cooper. Now, when he walked into that room, we were just in awe. Officers were emotional, but Cooper was actually laughing and joking around. But he did take some time to share with us the highs and the lows that he's been through after the shooting that changed his life. It's a moment many people never thought they would see. Officer Matt Cooper walking, smiling, and joking again with the officers and first responders who saved his life.
I never thought I'd be a 35-year-old learning how to walk and eat again.
Cooper was shot in the head last September during a shoplifting call at a Covington Walmart. Sitting down with us today, he says he's in therapy, getting stronger every day.
And I started vision therapy today to work on my vision. And I do that once a week for about 45 minutes to an hour. And I'm feeling great.
His wife, Kristen, has never left his side.
She's so strong and determined, caring, loving, athletic, and beautiful.
Through it all, Cooper hasn't lost his sense of humor, joking.
Check, check.
Posing for our cameras and making everyone laugh.
She's my rock. Or my lighthouse on a windy, stormy night.
Cooper says he doesn't remember much about the day he was shot.
Looking to my left, I see him in the woods, and that's it.
Sergeant Alan Ciberon found Cooper lying behind a store.
That situation on that day didn't look good when I found him, but to see how he's progressing today and how well he's doing physically, I know that it's God.
Cooper is forever grateful to his community.
The way y'all took care of me and my family when I couldn't just leaves me speechless.
And to everyone who worked and prayed for him to be here today.
I am forever indebted to you guys, and on my name and honor, I will try to make you guys proud. I will not let y'all down.
And the really good news in all of this is Cooper is done with all the surgeries. He tells us that he's learned to take things slower and to never take his family for granted. Sharon.
Yeah, we remember that day, that fateful day. Survival, that was not, you know, a done deal on this one, Haley. It really is a miracle, this story, for the officer, for everyone who's been supporting him. We know he's a veteran. He told you he's not done with policing even after this.
He's got a heart of service, Sharon. He served tours in Afghanistan and Iraq, and he says he plans to stay with the Covington Police as a mentor. And he also wants to train new officers. They're welcoming him back whenever he's ready.
Officer Cooper, he is remarkable. He really is a force. We appreciate it, Haley. We'll see you tonight for CBS 46 News at 11.